Welcome to my channel Beat the Math. I am Pavitra Munnayak. Today I need to discuss about the continuity and discontinuity of a function. This is Element of Mathematics, Exercise 7A, Question 1, Beat 8. The question is given, examine the continuity. Examine the continuity of the function the given function is f of x is equal to e to the power 1 by x minus 1 by e to the power 1 by x plus 1 if x not equal to 0. F of x is equal to 0 if x is equal to 0 at x is equal to 0. Given f of 0 is equal to 0, you see x is equal to 0, that means f of 0 is equal to 0. Left hand limit LHL. LHL is equal to limit x tends to 0 minus f of x is equal to limit x tends to 0 minus x not equal to 0, that is x tends to 0, I can take it the function e to the power 1 by x minus 1 by e to the power 1 by x plus 1 is equal to limit h tends to 0 e to the power 1 by 0 minus h minus 1 by e to the power 1 by 0 minus h plus 1 is equal to limit h tends to 0 e to the power minus 1 by h minus 1 by e to the power minus 1 by h plus 1 is equal to limit h tends to 0 1 by e to the power 1 by h minus 1 by 1 by e to the power 1 by h plus 1 is equal to, you see, if you put s tends to 0 e to the power 1 by h, that is 1 by 0, that is infinite, e to the power infinite is equal to infinite, 1 by infinite, any constant by infinite equal to 0, so 0 minus 1 by 0 plus 1, that is minus 1 by 1 is equal to minus 1. Next, RHL. Limit x tends to 0 plus f of x is equal to limit x tends to 0 plus e to the power 1 by x minus 1 by e to the power 1 by x plus 1. Pause the video, note it down. Then is equal to limit h tends to 0 e to the power 1 by, this is RHL, so we can take 0 plus h minus 1 by e to the power 1 by 0 plus h plus 1 is equal to limit h tends to 0 e to the power 1 by h minus 1 by e to the power 1 by h plus 1 divide by 1 by h both numerator and denominator is equal to limit h tends to 0 e to the power 1 by h minus 1 by e to the power 1 by h divide e to the power 1 by h plus 1 by e to the power 1 by h is equal to limit h tends to 0 1 minus 1 by e to the power 1 by h 1 plus 1 by e to the power 1 by h. Again put h tends to 0, that is h is equal to 0, then this become 1 by 1, 1 minus 1 by this is infinite, 1 by 0, 1 by 0 equal to infinite, e to the power infinite is equal to infinite, that is 1 minus any constant of infinite 0, this is also any constant of infinite 0, so 1 by 1 is equal to 1. Here LHL not is equal to RHL, the function does not exist, the function does not exist, therefore the function is discontinuous at x is equal to 0. You see the next question. The next question is, pause the video, note it down. Then you see next question. The next question is, question, that is question 9, f of x is equal to the same, examine the continuity of the function. The question is given, f of x is equal to 1 by x plus bracketed x if x less than 0, f of x is equal to minus 1 if x greater than equal to 0 at x is equal to 0, given, you see greater than equal to given, that means f of 0 is equal to minus 1. Again RHL also given, greater than equal to, that is RHL is also given, limit x tends to 0 plus f of x is equal to minus 1, this is also given. We have to find out the LHL. LHL is equal to limit x tends to 0 minus f of x is equal to limit x tends to 0 minus the function is given 1 by x plus bracketed x less than 0, that is 1 by x plus bracketed x is equal to limit, here I can take x tends to 0, h is a small positive integer, h tends to 0, 1 by, in place of x I can write 0 minus h plus 0 minus h, have to keep in bracket, is equal to limit h tends to 0, 1 by 0 minus h, that is minus h plus 0 minus h bracketed minus h is equal to limit h tends to 0 1 by minus h. You see h is a small positive integer, consider 0.001 and minus sign is here, suppose, then this is is equal to how much? This is a bracketed x function. So this is equal to minus 1. The lowest value we have to take. That is plus minus 1 is equal to limit h tends to 0 1 by minus h minus 1. If you put h is equal to 0, this is minus 1. So therefore LHL is equal to RHL is equal to f of 0. Therefore the function is the function is continuous at x is equal to 0. This is your question number 9. Pause the video, note it down. Next you see question number 10.